10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Three, two, and we're live. Hello, paranormal participants. You're listening to Paranormal Preaching on KVOC 820, where we can help spirits with their spiritual lives. I'm Susan Brunswick, and today is a very special broadcast. It simultaneously marks our 1,000th episode, as well as 5 incredible years on the air. Our show has spread from city to city to become nationwide, but we couldn't have gotten here without your support. Every day, we talk to lost souls from the afterlife who are looking to change their home address. From zombies to ghosts and even demons, if you're dead, this is a show for you. In today's historic episode, we'll be welcoming some of our very first guests back onto the show to see how their lives have improved for the better. Our first guest today is Jason. He's an undead zombie that lives near an abandoned campground, and he's killed a lot of people. But that was 5 years ago. So let's see what he's doing now. Jason, you're live.
Thanks, Susan. Glad to be back, and congrats on 5 years, by the way.
Why, thank you, Jace.
Well, things have really been looking out for me lately. I recently opened up a kids' campground called Jason's Jamboree. Every summer, hundreds of kids come down to Crystal Lake, and we have so much fun. Aside from the activities, I also host a Sunday sermon, and every night, kids memorize Bible verses around the campfire. I couldn't be happier with the way things are turning out, Susan.
Wow, Jason, what a courageous move. You built your new camp in the very spot where you used to kill people every summer. It takes a lot of guts to return to that place, to ignore those negative feelings and instead just do a lot of good. Truly incredible to hear that, Jason, and thank you for coming on the show today.
Absolutely, Susan. Until next time.
Alright, let's move right along to our next returning caller, Reverend Kane. The Reverend was a leader of an 1800s cult, and he...
Attention, all American citizens. This is an emergency alert to notify you that a deadly disease has spread to all corners of the earth and is now considered a worldwide pandemic. By order of the President, you are ordered to leave your jobs immediately and self-quarantine yourselves in your homes. You may only leave for the absolute essentials and nothing else. This is your only warning.
I think I'll just come back later.
Yes, Reverend. Thank you. I think that would be best. Thank you for coming on, nonetheless.
Whatever.
Well, listeners, we're going to have to wrap up our show pretty early today, and, I'll be honest. I don't know when we'll be coming back on the air. This virus is a real threat, and we all need to do our part to flatten a curve. So guys, wash your hands, stay safe, and above all, remember that God made you special, and he loves you very much. Goodbye, and good night for a while.
Dr. Singer, about the...
Well, hello there, y'all. I'm Aunt Martha. Are you tired of your old salad dressing? Does it flop out at parties, make you unpopular? Well, the answer to all your problems is in this little bottle. It's Aunt Martha's old-fashioned salad dressing. With 100% organic ingredients, you can spoon your way to health. It's so tasty too, honest. So for just $4.99, you can get...
Hello everyone, I'm Professor Evan. Do you ever have the problem of nutcase psychopaths chasing you around your place of business? Well, now you can escape them with the Time Gun 7 Pro. Simply select your destination, shoot yourself with the gun, and be whisked away to safety. I will demonstrate.
Oh! Always make sure it's a time gun and not a real gun! Only $49.99.
Howdy folks, I'm Rick Mathers, the big business tycoon from South Bend, Mississippi. Over the last 20 years, I've been spreading my shopping malls across America, and now I'm coming to you. I'll be buying up all your houses for a very lucrative price, and then slapping down there a brand new mall. Sorry about the move, folks, but business is business. And besides, who doesn't love a new mall? I'll be making my way to your store.
I love to sing.
Close the door, lock it now!
Dad, what are you doing here?
Just come here!
Okay. Dad, what is this all about?
Honey, I don't know how to say this, but I was just attacked by a toy.
A what?
It was one of those plush lambs. You know the kind. Anyways, I was sitting at home, and I thought I saw something move out of the corner of my eye. I ignored it. Thought, you know, my early onset dementia is getting to me. But then I saw it move again, like a lot.
Well, Dad, it could have been a number of things. A gust of wind could have knocked it over. I mean, did you have a window open?
No, Susan. This was no accident. The toy lamb, it rose right in front of me, 5 feet in the air.
5 feet?
Yes, 5 feet. And as if that wasn't bad enough, it started spinning and coming towards me.
What?
And then it flew at me and hit me. I mean, it's only a stuffed animal, so it wasn't a big deal. But the fact that it was flying sure does.
Well, then what did you do after that?
So it just kept throwing itself at me, and so I ran away, and I just barely escaped by leaving the house. And then I came straight here.
And they've broken through our defenses. This must be something stronger than we've ever encountered before. Did you call Phil from Afterlife Lock? I mean, we paid for the premium paranormal protection plan.
Oh, yes. I did forget, honey. I'll give him a call.
Don't worry about that, Dad. I'll call them first thing in the morning.
Why, thank you, dear.
In the meantime, you better head over to Mom's. It's not any safer for you here. Besides, we're supposed to be self-quarantining anyway.
Well, maybe I'll just, you know, stay in a hotel or something.
Dad, I know you and Mom haven't always seen eye to eye, but what other choice do you have?
The choice of a hotel!
Dad!
Fine, well, she better not make me clean the garage or anything. She's always nagging about something.
Just try to remember how you two were when you were first married. You'll survive.
I suppose.
Don't worry, Dad. I'm gonna take care of this, and everything's gonna be okay.
I know it will, honey, because you're the best at what you do.
Thanks, Dad.
Bye now.
Bye.
Make sure to feed your goldfish. You looked really hungry earlier.
Just get out. Okay.
How you doing, ma'am? How you doing today?
Aren't you the guy I just saw on TV? Like Rick Mather or something?
In the flesh. I'm sorry for the lateness of the hour, but I thought I'd come over.
I know why you're here. And no, I don't want to sell my house. And no, I don't care how much you'd pay me. And no, I don't need a new mall. So, like you said, it's really late, and I need to go to bed. So goodbye.
Yeah, but I just...
Yeah, yeah, just goodbye.
I mean, I have a lot of things you might be interested in.
finally time to hit the hay. Aye. 9 a.m. Looks good. What was that?
Of a medical emergency.
I've been shot!
Only in the arm. You'll live.
It still hurts. Heal me.
As you wish. What do I know? I only have access to every part of the internet.
Do you know how to beat a malevolent entity that's possessing things then?
I'm a doctor, not a psychic. I get it.
What's going on?
Someone's tampering with my source box. My box has just been shot. Goodbye.
Good enough. Come on, Phil, pick up the phone.
You reached after NASA. This is Phil. How may I direct your call?
Phil, it's Susan.
Oh, hi. It's my favorite Ghostbuster. What's up, Sue?
No, I don't have time for games, Phil. There's a crazy spirit floating in my house trying to kill me. I thought I bought the premium paranormal protection plan.
You did. Well, I think. Let me take a look. I'm pulling it up now. Okay, yeah, everything seems to be in order on my end. Plan's all paid up.
Well, I don't know what to tell you, but I really have a problem here.
Well, what's going on?
Well, first, my dad had objects flying around his house, and now I do too. Oh, and then a floating gun just shot me.
Oh my gosh.
What?
Susan, our spirit protection service is extremely strong, but if that many things move at that rate of speed, this is something else.
Well, what could do something like that?
Something more powerful. Something more powerful than our systems can handle. Something beyond our control.
Well, what could it be?
It could be the, no, that's just a legend.
What? Tell me!
Well...
Great. Just great. It's dead. Perfect. Well, whatever's down there is just gonna have to wait because I'm tired.
We are the Mist. The one, the many.
What do you want me to do?
Die.
Misty, you won't scare me out of my house. I'm not afraid.
You will be.
You have one new message.
Susan, I was right! There's an incredibly strong spirit in your house! It calls itself the Mist! You're not not the only one. It's all over the news. It's here, Susan. You gotta get out of there before it gets you too. Run, Susan, run!
Trying to kill myself, honest. I think it's a spirit or something. I just came back to get my wallet, you know?
I know all about it, Dad, okay? I'm gonna get you out. Just don't move. Now, Dad, hold still.
Honey?
Shh! Don't move. Let me aim.
Because if we don't get out of this alive...
Shut up. Let me aim.
No, I'm gonna finish. You know, whatever happens, I just want you to know that you're the best daughter a guy could ever hope for, you know?
Got it. Move, Dad! Run now! Go! Go! You're no super demon! Just a guy that's invisible. Which means I can beat you. Oh, yeah, you better run.
Mr. Mist. Come out wherever you are. Return to the scene of the crime, eh? I know you're here. You can't hide forever. Get up, nice and slow. Rick Mathers?
In the flesh.
Ah, dang you!
What in the name of Brunswick possessed you to attack me like that?
It wasn't personal. Me and the boys hit all the houses on this street. I knew the homeowners wouldn't sell easily, so I figured a good old-fashioned haunting would do the trick. Most folks backed down a long time before you did, so things got a little out of hand for you. Stop it!
You idiot! I had barely seen you on TV just a few minutes before.
I'm not uninformed. I knew your occupation. I figured I could get a head start on things.
So you scared the life out of a 60-year-old man?
Whatever it takes to make the cake. That's what I always say.
This is for my dad.
We're live with NUT7 News. I'm Jim Beam, filling in for Jack Daniels. Breaking news today, billionaire mall tycoon Rick Mathers and five of his employees have just been arrested on multiple charges of assault and attempted murder. But that's not all. Apparently, they tried to fool the citizens of a small town into thinking that they were the fabled super demon, the Mist. Thanks to the actions of paranormal talk show host Susan Brunswick, Mathers has safely been taken into custody. We'll have more on that as the story develops. In other news, the raging pandemic continues to plague the globe. So stay home, stay safe, and please wash your hands. Back to you, Beck.
I'm so glad to hear you're all healed up, Phil. Oh, I gotta go. My show's starting soon, okay? Bye. Hello, paranormal participants. I'm Susan Brunswick on Paranormal Preaching, and I'm back in the air just like normal. Well, not quite. I'm airing this from my home, but it's so great that I can continue my show and talk to you guys and still stay safe. I'm sure you all heard about my epic matchup with The Mist, and so we'll be talking all about that on the show today. I have a very special guest here. Please welcome my dad, Ward.
Well, hello, radio people!
So, everyone wants to know all about how this whole Mist thing got started.
Oh, you wouldn't believe it. Well, I was at my home, and all of a sudden I saw objects levitating in the air. And so I went over to your house to tell you all about it. And then after that I went back again to get my wallet. And well, after that, that's... Well, if you really wanted to get the whole picture, it's like... Well, I mean, let me back up just a bit. Say something.
Why don't we just go to commercial break? We'll be right back.
Well, hello there, y'all. I'm Aunt Martha. Are you tired of the old salad?
Dad, are you okay?
It's just too soon, honey. It's just too soon.
Dad.
We almost died, Susan. I don't even know if you realize that.
I know. But he's locked up now. We're safe again.
That's true, but... But gosh, Susan. Oh my gosh.
It'll be okay. It'll only get better from here. I promise you, that'll never ever happen to you again.
I sure hope so, sweetie. But, okay. I can make an honest broadcast. I'll do it.
Are you sure?
Yeah, definitely. I wouldn't want to ruin your show.
All right, then. And welcome back to Paranormal Preaching on KVOC 820. We're continuing to talk with my dad, Ward Brunswick, on my dangerous encounter with the Mist. Dad?
So it all started when I went back to the house to get my keys.
Wallet.
And I was choked by a floating sword.
You don't say.
It was no fun at all, believe me.
Well, I can see.